Hello YouTube, and okay, see you again. And today I'm gonna show you how to install App Inventor and the latter versions on your Windows 10 or Windows 7, Windows 8, whatever on a Windows version you are. So all the links are in the description box. You can check it out. And the first thing before you install the App Inventor, you must have a Java installed on your computer. If you don't have one, just take a look at Java website and install it. And if you have done a Java installed on your computer, and now you just need to open a link. I provide it in the description. You can check it. So my last version is 4.0. So I think it's good for me. I open it. Sorry, my internet connection is very slow now. So this is what you have, the portable version or installer. I click on the installer version because I don't need a portable. And you need two files. If you are running on 32-bit version, please download your 32-bit, and 64-bit version, just download a 64-bit. So just download 64-bit AI to use 64-bit and AI starter for version 4. So this means that you need to download these two together, and you can have a completely working App Inventor for your offline working. So after you download it, just click on download, and it will prompt you to the download location. So this will start downloading, but I downloaded it already, so I have two files over here. So this is the version 4 that I have. So just open it. First thing I open, I start install AI2 starter. So just wait until it finish. And now it's done. So after you done AI starter, you need to install AI to you 64-bit version, because my window is 64-bit, so I install 64-bit version for my PC. Double click it to open the program and wait. Okay, now it go, and just click next. Oh, it is here. You need to create a desktop icon to see it's on my desktop, but actually I hide all my desktop icon because it's really messy. So now just wait until this is done, and we'll skip it. So now a program is done installing. It takes me about 2 minutes, and after you finish it, just click on finish. So I close this all because it's not necessary anymore. And I search for App Inventor. Inventor. This one, App Inventor Server. Just click on it, and you will get this two or three terminal window. So just look at this one. Server is running. Yeah, I need to find it. This one. Just need to find it, and the default location is HTTP localhost, and the port is 84 time maybe. I don't know how to spell it. And so just copy it and open in your favorite browser. So for me, I'm using Chrome, and now I can disable my internet connection. So just wait. But now I don't have internet connection, and for here it needs an email address and a password, but you don't have to fill it. Just click on it make me actually confused. Click here to use your Google account login. So just click on it and click login. After you log in, and you will have this blank page. You will have a blank page, but I have create a project previously before I install and uninstall it, so it's patched on my computer. But For you just need to click on start a new project and give your project name, for example, a test project. And your project name must be don't have space. Test project. So now you have two different projects. I click on save project. Yeah, it's on my project. So I have two projects. One is Bluetooth controller, and so this one is iMac. And I will not go deeply to how to use this app. You can Google it or YouTube, search in YouTube about how to use it. So it basically, I just show you how to install this app. Yeah, thank you for watching this video. If you have questions, please give it in comment below. I will be reply as soon as I available. And don't forget to like and subscribe for me. Goodbye.